Good morning to all of you. My name is Dr. Abhay Deshpande, Associate Professor, RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. So today I am going to have a session on magnetic forces, a unit number 4 in electromagnetic field theory, that is 18EE45. So under magnetic forces, today I am going to cover force on a moving charge, force on a differential current element, and third one is force between differential current elements. So let me start with an introduction. So until now, we have done many basic laws and techniques used to calculate the magnetic field B due to current carrying element. Now this is the time to study the force a magnetic field exerts on a charged particles, current elements, and loops. So such a study is very much important to problems on electrical devices such as ammeter, voltmeter, galvanometers, cyclotrons, plasmas, motors, and magneto-hydrodynamic generators. So the force due to magnetic fields, so there are totally three ways in which a force due to magnetic fields can be experienced. That is, the force can be on a moving charge. Second one is, the force can be on a differential current element. And third one is, the force can be between differential current elements. So let me start with the first one. That is force on a moving charge. The electric force Fe on a stationary or a moving electric charge Q in an electric field is given by Coulomb's experimental law and is related to the electric field intensity capital E as Fe is equal to Q into E newtons, where Q is electric charge and E is electric field intensity and Fe is electric force. So let me call this as equation 1, that is electric force on a moving electric charge in an electric field. So this is because of an electric field. Now let me consider the magnetic force. I will denote magnetic force as Fm. So Fm is the magnetic force experienced by a charge Q moving with a velocity V in a magnetic field B. It is given by Fm is equal to Q into V cross B, where Q is a charge which is moving with a velocity V, that is V, and B is the magnetic field and Fm is the magnetic force which is measured in terms of newtons. So in this equation, that is magnetic force Fm, the force Fm is always perpendicular to the plane containing V and B. So this is V and B, and there is an angle theta, and the Fm is perpendicular to the plane having containing V and B. Now we have seen both the equation, that is because of electric field and because of magnetic field. Now let us calculate the total force, that is for a moving charge Q in the presence of both electric and magnetic fields. Then the total force on a charge is given by the total force EF is equal to Fe plus Fm, where Fe is electric force and Fm is the magnetic force. Now we have derived the equation for Fe. Fe is Q into E and Fm is Q into V cross B. So I have taken Q outside common and I have written it as E plus V cross B newtons. So this is the total force in the presence of both electric as well as magnetic field. So this equation is generally called as Lorentz force equation. That is the total force equation. We will call it as Lorentz force equation. Now let us do an example problem on this to understand the clarity of the concepts. A point charge of Q is equal to minus 1.2 coulombs has a velocity V is equal to 5ax plus 2ay minus 3az meter per second. Find the magnitude of the force exerted on the charge if, first one, electric field, that is minus 18x plus 5ay minus 10az volts per meter. And second one is magnetic field, that is minus 4ax plus 4ay plus 3az tesla. And third one is when both are present simultaneously. So in the equation, electric field intensity, that is capital E, is there, and the magnetic flux density B is there, and they have given both E and B, and they are asking all the three conditions: when only electric field is there, when only magnetic field is there, and when both are present simultaneously. Now they have given the charge value Q and also the velocity V in meter per second. Now let me start for the first one. That is, the electric force exerted by E on a charge Q, it is given by Fe is equal to Q into E. That is our first equation, where Q is the charge and E is electric field intensity. And we will substitute the value Q is equal to minus 1.2 and E is equal to minus 18ax plus 5ay minus 10az, which is given in the numerical. Now you multiply the value of Q into E. So we will get it as minus 1.2 into minus 18ax, that is 21.6ax, minus 1.2 plus 5, that is minus 6ay, minus 1.2 minus 10, that is plus 12az newtons. So let us calculate the magnitude of this. That is, Fe is equal to under root of 21.6 whole square plus minus 6 whole square plus 12 whole square. And I will get this value as 25.4275 newtons. So this is the electric force exerted by E on a charge Q. Now similarly, calculate the second case. That is, the magnetic force exerted by B on a charge Q. So we know the equation, that is Fm is equal to Q into V cross B. Let us substitute all the values, Q value, V value, as well as B value. So in the numerical, they have given all the values Q, V and B. So Q value minus 1.2 coulombs, B value minus 4ax plus 4ay plus 3az tesla, and B value is 5ax plus 2ay minus 3az. Substitute all the values, Q value minus 1.2 V value as well as value of B. Now let us multiply first Q with V. So I will get this equation as minus 1.2 into 5 minus 6 AX minus 1.2 into 2 minus 2.4 AY and minus 1.2 into minus 3, that is plus 3.6 AZ. And I maintain B value as it is, that is minus 4AZ plus 4AY plus 3AZ as it is. Now I need to calculate the cross product of these two. So let us find out the cross product AX, AY, AZ and fill with the first row, that is minus 6. Minus 2.4 plus 3.6. Fill the second row, minus 4 plus 4 and plus 3. So now we will calculate the cross product, that is AX as it is, the first column. AX we have maintained constant. Then 3 into minus 2.4, that is minus 7.2, minus 4 into 3.6, that is 14.4 AX. For the second term, that is minus AY, let us write minus AY, that is second column, we need to leave now and we need to multiply this, minus 6 into 3, that is minus 18 and minus of minus 4 into 3.6, that is plus 4 into 3.6, we will get it as 14.4 AY. Do the third one, plus AZ as it is, third column we need to leave. Then minus 6 into 4, minus 24 and minus of minus into minus, that is plus 4 into 2.4, we will get 9.6 minus 9.6 AZ. So let us simplify this. We will get it as minus 21.6 AX plus 3.6 AY minus 33.6 AZ newtons. Now calculate the magnitude of this, that means under root of 21.6 whole square plus 3.6 whole square plus minus 33.6 whole square, that is equal to 40.1058 newtons. So this is the magnetic force exerted by B on a charge Q. That is Fm is equal to 40.1058 newtons. Now let us take the third condition, third case, that is when both the fields are present, that is electric field as well as magnetic field, then the total force exerted by both the fields on a charge is given by total force F is equal to Fe plus Fm, electric as well as magnetic, is equal to Q into E plus V cross B. So that is Q into E plus Q into V cross B. Substitute all the values. So we have already calculated Q into E and Q into V cross B. Just write those values. Let us see where we have calculated Q into E. Q into E is minus 20 minus 6 AY, that is 21.6 AX minus 6 AY plus 12 AZ is Q into E, and Q into V cross B we have calculated as minus 21.6 AX plus 3.6 AY minus 33.6 AZ, that is FE and FM. Let us substitute both FE value as well as FM value. Now add these two, that is FE plus FM. So if you add, AX component will become 0 because plus 21.6 minus 21.6, it leads to 0. AY component is minus 6 plus 3.6. We will get minus 2.4 AY. And AZ component is plus 12 and minus 33.6. We will get it as minus 21.6 AZ newtons. Now let us calculate the magnitude of the total force, that is F is equal to under root of 0 square plus minus 2.4 square plus minus 21.6 square, that is equal to 21.7329 newtons. So this is the total force exerted by both the fields, that is electric field as well as magnetic field. So this is how we will calculate the force exerted by fields on a charge. So with this concept, let me go to the next one, second one, that is force on a differential current element. Now the force exerted on a differential element of charge dq moving in a steady magnetic field is given by df is equal to dq into v cross b. So we know that F is equal to Q into V cross B in the first case. Now, since it is a differential element of charge dQ, then the force exerted also DF. So we will get it as DF is equal to dQ into V cross B newton, where dq is our differential element of charge in a steady magnetic field. Now let us recall some equations, that is the current density J is given by J is equal to rho v into v, where rho v is volume charge, V. Then the differential element of charge dq, dq we will write it as rho v dv from our basic laws. So we know these two equations, that is current density J and the differential element of charge, that is dq. So let us substitute the value of dq in the equation of df, that is force, then we will get this equation as df is equal to, so instead of dq we will write it as rho v into dv. So let us replace this dq as rho v into dv, then v as it is cross b. Now let us express this df in terms of current density J. That is, we know from the basic principles that J is equal to rho v into v. So in the equation of df, the rho v into v, we will write it as the current density J. Then this b as it is the magnetic field into D. So this is the DF which we have expressed in terms of current density J. Now we know that volume charge, surface charge and line all are related as J into dV is equal to K into dS is equal to I into dl. That is surface, line and volume. So in the equation, J into dV can be replaced by I into dl. So the equation of dF becomes IdL cross V. IdL cross V is the equation of dF. Now, if you take the integral for a closed path, the line integral becomes F is equal to integral of IdL cross V. Now for the same equation, if you consider for a straight and long current carrying conductor, then this equation can be written as F is equal to I L cross V. So this is the force exerted on a differential element of charge dQ. So we need to start from the equation of F is equal to Q into V cross B, and we need to differentiate and we need to calculate the value of F is equal to I L cross B. Let us take one example. A conductor 6 meter long lies along Z direction with a current of 2 ampere in AZ direction. Find the force experienced by conductor if B is equal to 0.08 AX Tesla. So there is a conductor of 6 meter long. It is lying along Z direction and it has a current of 2 ampere in AZ direction, and we need to calculate the force experienced by the conductor, and they have given the value of B, that is magnetic flux density is 0.08 AX Tesla. So we know the equation F is equal to IdL cross B. So I value they have given as 2 ampere, DL value is 6 AZ, that is length is 6 meter long and it is lying along that direction. So we will write it as 6 AZ and I value is 2 ampere. Substitute I value, DL value cross B. B is magnetic field, that is 0.08 AX. Now let us multiply this 2 into 6. We will get it as 12 AZ cross 0.08 AX. Now we need to calculate the cross product of these two. That is AZ cross AX is nothing but AY, and 12 cross 0.08, we will get it as 0.96 AY Newton. So this is how we will calculate the force . Now with this concept, let me move to the third one, that is force between differential current elements. Now I have taken two differential elements, that is DL1 and DL2, two currents I1 and I2, and I need to calculate the force between these two current elements. now. Force exerted on a differential current element, it is given by D of DF1 is equal to I1 DL1 cross DB2. That is, I1 DL1 is for the first current element and DB2 is for the magnetic field for the second element. So this equation tells that what is the force exerted between the first element with the second element, that is DB2. So what is the value of DB2? We need to calculate the value of DB2. See, this equation we have already seen in the previous examples and previous concepts. Now same thing we need to use here. But only thing is, it is between two differential current element, where in which the first element is I1 DL1. The force because of second element on the first element is the cross product we are calculating, that is I1 DL1 cross DB2, and calculate the value of DB2. That is, DB2 is equal to mu naught into DH2, and mu naught value as it is. And now we have to use the concept of Biot-Savart's law. So using the concept of Biot-Savart's law for the second differential current element, we will write it as DH2, we will write it as I2 DL2, that is second current element, differential element, cross AR21 whole divided by 4 pi R21 whole square, where R21 is the distance. So we have used the concept of Biot-Savart's law to substitute the value of DS2. Hence, we have calculated the value of DB2. Now substitute this value of DB2 in the equation of force. Then the force equation becomes I1 DL1 cross this entire DB2 value. So we can write this equation as D of DF1 is equal to mu naught constant as it is, I1 DL1 as it is, cross DB2 value is I2 DL2 cross AR21 whole divided by 4 pi R21 square. Now let us simplify further. We will get F1 value as mu naught is a constant, I1 and I2 are also constant, divided by 4 pi is a constant. Now the DL1 and DL2, we need to do the integration for a closed path, one with respect to L2 and one with respect to L1. So first we will do with respect to L2, and then we will do with respect to L1 for a closed path, and this is the equation of the force. Now similarly, if you calculate the force on the second current element because of the first, then we will get the equation as mu naught I2 into I1 divided by 4 pi into integration of DL2 cross DL1 cross of A R12 divided by R12 whole square. Now see, first we need to integrate with respect to L1. Then we need to integrate with respect to L2. And here it is R21 and here it is R12. So in general, if you calculate the force between two long straight and parallel conductor carrying a current, then these equations can be written as F is equal to mu I1 into I2 into L, that is the length, divided by 2 pi d, where d is the distance. So this equation is nothing but the force between two long straight and parallel conductors. So let us do one simple example on this. So the problem is, find the force per meter length between two long parallel wires separated by 10 centimeter in air and carrying a current of 10 ampere in the same direction. So we need to calculate the force per meter length. That is F divided by L we need to calculate. Now in the equation of F is equal to mu into I1 I2 L divided by 2 pi d, I need to calculate F divided by L because I need force per meter length, and I can write it as mu naught into I1 I2 divided by 2 pi d. Mu naught value, substitute 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. Ia, Ib, that is nothing but I1, I2. So the current is 10 ampere. So I will write 10 into 10 divided by 2 pi d, where d is the distance. So they are separated by a distance of how much? 10 centimeter. So let us write it as 2 pi into 0.1 and calculate what is the force per meter length. So we will get the answer as F by L is equal to force per meter length is equal to 2 into 10 to the power minus 4 Newton per meter. So this is how we will do the example. Now we have done the three concepts today, and let us have some quiz questions. First one, the magnitude of the force on a straight and a long current carrying conductor is given by F is equal to ILV, first option. Second one is F is equal to ILB sin theta. Third one, F is equal to ILB cos theta. And fourth option is F is equal to IB sin theta. Question is, the magnitude of the force on a straight and long current carrying a conductor is given by, it is option B, that is F is equal to ILB sin theta. Let us do the second quiz. The question is, if the currents in two conducting loops are with the same orientations, then the circular loops will experience option A, force of attraction, option B, force of repulsion, option C, equal force, and last one is it is equal to zero. Answer is option A, that is, if the currents in the two conducting loops are with the same orientations, then the circular loops will experience force of attraction. So these are the answers to the quiz questions what we have seen. So today we have seen the three concepts, that is force on a moving charge, second one is on a differential current element, and third one is between differential current elements. So those three concepts we have seen today. So that was the outline which I wanted to do. So we will continue with the next session in the next class. So thank you very much. Thank you.